The bracelet is worthless, mademoiselle. It is copper only. I bought it outside the train station in Istanbul for my arthritis. Take it if you like.
I'm very sorry, Your Highness. I realize how this must look, but I'm only doing the job assigned me. I promise I'll return it to you, if I can.
Ah, then I expect you would like to interrogate me. I believe that is the correct term.
If I may.
But of course. I am suspect, just as anyone in the galley coach must be. I am ready for the third degree.
I have borrowed your passport, Your Highness.
I noticed that as well.
Natalia Dragomirov, 17 Avenue Kleber, Paris. You are traveling home from Istanbul, madame?
Yes. I have been staying at the Austrian embassy. My maid is with me, as you saw in the marketplace.
Could you give me a brief account of your movements last evening?
Nothing could be simpler. After dinner, Schmidt, my maid, read to me. We were interrupted by the train stopping to avoid the avalanche. Then she read aloud to me some more until quite late.
Can you give me an idea of the time?
If I were to guess, I would say it was 1:30.
Has your maid been with you long?
15 years.
Do you consider her trustworthy?
Absolutely. Her people come from an estate of my late husband's in Germany.
Forgive the personal nature of this question, madame, but what is the color of your dressing gown?
My dressing gown? It is of blue satin.
I regret to tell you that I must take your fingerprints.
Dear me. With typewriting ribbon? Have you something I may clean my hands with afterwards?
I have some paper napkins.
Thank you, mademoiselle. Those should suit admirably.
You have been in America, I presume, madame?
Many times.
Were you acquainted with a family by the name of Armstrong?
You speak of friends of mine, mademoiselle. Sonia Armstrong was my goddaughter. I was on terms of friendship with her mother, Linda Arden, one of the greatest tragic actresses in the world. As Lady Macbeth, as Nora in A Doll's House, there was no one to touch her. I was not only an admirer of her art, I was a personal friend.
Is Linda Arden dead?
No, she is alive. It is a sort of life. She lives in complete retirement. Her health is very delicate. She must lie on a sofa most of the time.
Mrs. Armstrong had a sister, did she not?
Yes, much younger than Mrs. Armstrong.
And she is alive?
Certainly.
Where is she?
I must ask the reason of these questions. What have they to do with the murder on this train?
The dead man was responsible for the kidnapping and death of Mrs. Armstrong's child.
Ah. In my view, then, this murder is an entirely admirable occurrence. You will pardon my slightly biased point of view.
It is most natural, madame. Where is the younger daughter of Linda Arden, the sister of Mrs. Armstrong?
I've lost touch with the younger generation. I believe she married an Englishman some years ago, but at the moment I cannot recollect the name. Mademoiselle, you will forgive me, but the one you assist, he who guides the investigation, no one has told me his name.
He is Hercule Poirot, madam.
Poirot. Of course. I thought his face was somehow familiar to me. Poirot on this train. It is destiny.
Colonel Arbuthnot, I do not believe we've been properly introduced.
I expect the formalities must be winked at in a case like this, mademoiselle. The attendant told me you are acting on the frog detective's behalf.
I am the frog, monsieur. Hercule Poirot is Belgian.
Apologies, no offense meant. Your accent's a bit of mid-channel, difficult to pick up.
May I have your passport, please?
Of course.
Colonel Francis Gordon Arbuthnot, the Muse, Cheltenham, Royal Northumberland Fusiliers, currently stationed in India.
Yes, on leave.
But you're not traveling on the P&O boat? Why not?
I stopped in Baghdad with the AOC, who happens to be a good friend of mine.
Where did you meet Mademoiselle Debenham?
Miss Debenham? What in... In Baghdad, if you must know.
And your opinion of her?
You can take it from me, she's all right. A Pooka Sahib.
Can you give me an account of your movements last night?
Yes, I think I can. After dinner, I had a drink in the salon car with young McQueen, the dead man's secretary. Surprisingly knowledgeable about world affairs for an American, even if he had got hold of some tomfool ideas about India. We adjourned to his compartment, let me see, around 2100, that's 9 p.m. You saw us in the Belgrade station courtyard. We stepped out for a bit of fresh air, but with the weather turning foul, that wasn't on.
I will take your fingerprints now.
Will you, by Jove? Well, get on with it then.
What do you and Monsieur McQueen smoke?
McQueen doesn't, now that I think of it. A pipe's my weapon of choice.
What happened after Belgrade?
Around 2200, that's 10 p.m. Ratchet's valet came to fetch him for his employer. He went off for a while.
And what did you do after Monsieur McQueen left you?
Well, I went back to the salon car for a nightcap, didn't I? I was heading to my compartment when I ran into McQueen. Went off back to his room again to continue the natter. I put him straight on India. Learned a bit about the American stock market. Bloody fool's game, if you ask me. Oh, pardon my... That is to say, my language.
Do not concern yourself.
There, you see. Now I can hear the accent. It comes and goes.
What time did your discussion of world affairs end?
The conversation was so engrossing, by the time I looked at my watch, it was 1:45. McQueen called the attendant to make up his bed. I came back here.
Did anyone pass Monsieur McQueen's room while you were talking?
A good many people, I should think. I wasn't paying attention. The attendant did at one point, and I think I caught a glimpse of you wandering about.
Let us say during the last hour of your conversation.
Really, I can't.
Colonel, you have the soldier's observation for detail.
Hang on. There was a woman, I think.
Was this woman young or old?
Didn't see her, wasn't looking that way. Just a rustle in a scent.
Mademoiselle Debenham?
No, I'd recognize. That is to say, it wasn't. No, it was very strong. Fruit or something.
Can you pinpoint the time the woman passed? What were you discussing?
Let's see, I was detailing the other washout. Stalin's 5-year plan was turning out. It must have been within the last half hour. More definite than that, I can't say.
Have you ever been in America?
Never. Don't want to go.
Did you ever know a Colonel Armstrong?
Armstrong? Armstrong. I've known 2 or 3 Armstrongs. Selby Armstrong. He was killed on the Somme.
I mean the Colonel Armstrong who married an American woman and whose only child was kidnapped and murdered.
Ah, yes. I remember reading about that shocking affair. Never actually came across the fellow, but his name came up in the officer's mess, of course. Toby Armstrong. Nice fellow. Everybody liked him. Distinguished career, got the VC, Victoria Cross.
The man who was killed last night was the man responsible for the murder of Colonel Armstrong's child.
Then in my opinion, the swine got what he deserved, though I would have preferred to see him properly hanged or electrocuted or whatever it is they do over there. Trial by 12 good men and true. Sound system.
Anything you can recall from last night that strikes you as suspicious?
There was one odd thing.
Yes?
As I got back to my compartment, I noticed that the door of the one beyond mine, number 16, it wasn't quite closed. The chap inside peered out in a rather furtive sort of way, then quickly pulled the door. Probably nothing in it, but you know what it is. Early hours of the morning, everything very still. The think had a sinister look. Like a detective story.
Thank you, Colonel Arbuthnot.
Not at all. Now, if you don't mind, I think I'll pop along to the salon car.
Don't let me keep you.
You mean to say you intend to stay in my compartment?
Yes.
And search through my belongings?
I'm sorry, but I really must.
But that's... I mean, it just isn't... That's bloody irregular. Pardon my French.